Welcome to the Food Packaging and Storage Laboratory. In today's lab, we will learn about the automatic form, fill and seal machine for the solid items. As we can understand by the name itself of the machine that this machine involves three major processes. First one will be the forming of the packaging material. The second one will be the filling of the solid product into the packaging material. And third process will be the sealing of the packets to get final packed product. So now we will learn about the components of the automatic form, fill and seal machine. This machine includes the control unit, the gearbox unit and motor unit, the third section will be our dosing section. From the top of this hopper to this volumetric section. This will be our dosing section. The fourth section will be the forming section. From this roller to the first sealing jaw will be our forming section. The fifth section will be our sealing section. This one is the first sealing section and this one is the second sealing section. This is for the vertical sealing, whereas the down one will be for the horizontal sealing. Now coming to the control unit. This control unit will include the digital transducer that will convert the motion and other parameters to the electrical signal. So due to this, we can see all the readings such as temperatures and number of packets that packed in a given time. Here, temperature controller is also there so that we can change the temperature and temperature of the sealing jaws. So here the sealing jaws will be having some certain temperature that we can set from this temperature controller. Next one will be our gearbox unit and motor unit. Here the motor that has been provided that rotates at around 1440 rpm, that is too much for packaging of the granular product. So to reduce the rpm of the motor, here the compound gear section have been placed. So due to this compound gear section, the speed of the motor will reduce and the less speed will deliver to this dosing section. So within the less speed of the dosing section, certain volume of the product will come towards the down hopper and the product will be packed. The third section is the dosing section. The fourth section is the forming section, as I have explained earlier. And the fifth section is the sealing section. There are some steps that involve in the filling sequence. So the first step that will be involved in the filling section will be our packaging material unwinding. Here we can see that we have got the packaging reel. So the first step is to unwind the packaging reel. This packaging reel will be unwinded and pulled and tensioned by these several rollers. As we can see here, there's 3 to 4 rollers are there. By using that, the tension will be created and this packaging material will come down and it will position through this way, as we can see here. Any kind of packaging material, mainly the flexible packaging material, we can place. So for example, aluminium foil, plastic laminate or even paper is delivered in this particular roll. So basically, here the packaging material that has been provided is the bilayer packaging material, that is the combination of polyethylene and aluminium foil, but based on the requirement it can be modified also. The next step that involves in this section is the forming of the pouch. This is the forming tube. So the specific part of forming tube is called the forming shoulder. So the packaging material is then twisted. As we can see here, the packaging material is then twisted around the forming tube and pulled all along the tube which enables the next stage of the filling process. The step number 3 will be our vertical sealing. So here we can see that here is the vertical sealing jaws through which the packaging material will come and it will seal here. A couple of sealing jaws and sealing or sealing bars is then used. This is used to press against each other. The material should be overlapped with each other, and the sealing jaws will weld them to create the side seal. Here the side seal will be done. Next step will be the bottom sealing. So here this is the second sealing jaw. The product cannot yet be fed to the filling tubes as no bottom seal to the pouch. It is done by another couple of sealing bars that are also welding the material through the heating. So the next step is the product filling. The dosing system position about the forming tube can finally be run in order to dose the amount of the product. So the material falling down through the tube inside of one pouch being pressed. Here is the second hopper. This is the volumetric area through which the material will come in certain volume and it will come down to the next hopper. Through this, material will go inside the packaging material and it will weld together in the first sealing jaws. Once the material will be fed, then the top sealing will be horizontal sealing will be done and the material will come inside the packaging material and the horizontal sealing will be done. The next section will be cutting. So once this product will be sealed, the material will come out of the sealing jaws and we can cut and collect the sample. So now we have understood the purpose and components of the automatic form, fill and seal machine. So let us see the working operation of the machine. So this is one switch through which we have to switch it on. So here we can see that this is the two temperature controller display. In which first temperature controller display will be for the vertical sealing jaws and the second temperature controller display will be for the horizontal sealing jaws. So we can control the temperature based on the thickness of the packaging material. Different temperature will be required for sealing it. Here we have optimized 100 to 110 degrees Celsius for this packaging material for the vertical jaws, and for horizontal sealing we have optimized 115 degrees Celsius. So this machine will take some time to come with this this temperature. This jaws will take some time, so we can wait for some time. That the number of packets which is coming out of the machine, it is mentioned measuring here due to this photo sensor. This photo sensor will sense this black mark from one point to the different point, and it will measure the amount of packaging amount of packet based on this photo mark. Here we can set the timing and we can check the capacity of the packaging machine.